Hello everyone, and welcome to another World War Z video guide. My name is Renier 888, and today we're moving forward in Tokyo in the second level, Final Call. As usual, let's start with the recommended classes, and I do suggest to use the Hellraiser, which will be quite effective throughout the whole level. Otherwise, if you're a little experienced with the level, you can of course use other classes, such as the Exterminator, the Gunslinger, or the Slasher, although they do lack in specific, in some specific sections compared to the Hellraiser. The first part of the mission is as usually a stealth mission. You just have to be careful to not make noise, be careful right in the corners here as you start, there is potential to find creepers, and as you saw right off the bat, a potential first breach in charge location. There are three scenarios you can encounter here. You can only find either only Zeke, Zeke with enemy claymores, or Zeke with enemy auto turrets. You don't have to be extra careful because either your character or the bots will start yelling what type of enemy defense is on the ground, and you just have to be a little careful, although there is a lag factor. Sometimes the enemy auto turrets, the placement will automatically shoot the Zeke, making noise, or some Zeke may stumble upon the enemy claymores, making noise, and that's something you cannot control, and you can either restart because it's the start of the level, or you can defend because usually when they make noise they don't spawn many special Zeke as long as your bots do not make extensive noise. Here we will find inside this pod a potential breach in charge location on the right, and I do suggest to search the whole this small pond because sometimes you can find other resources such as medkits. Apart from that, it's not always worth it to come from this part because there is of course a chance to spawn a weapon even on top of these rocks. Otherwise, on the right you saw a door we opened, and there is 100% chance to find a supply crate in there, which is quite nice to always check for more supplies. Here on the left there is a third potential breaching charge location, and you have to make sure you save your breaching charge. Do not open this breaching door. It's quite important that we have to save it for later. After we proceed even further and open both doors, do not rush things, finish off all the Zeke, do not cross these yellow lines, otherwise you will trigger the next step and you will get attacked and you will not have time to search the area. Make sure you have the full stamina bar, check always behind this white car, most of the times there will be a supply crate, otherwise quick check these shelves and immediately drop down. Because we're getting attacked by Zeke as we speak, and soon special Zeke will spawn, it's a little important to move as fast as we can while doing some things. Here on the left you can check and see if there is a supply crate you can open. Move and fire, it's most effective. Check your rear if you're getting attacked by Zeke. Run here, just be careful on the left if there is a lurker, and go take position by the track where we will defend and fend off the special Zeke. Here on the left there is a chance for a defense kit or a supply crate, and below the track as you saw there is a chance for the next potential breaching charge location. Now since we have spec'd a little differently, we have the improved MGL that will help us for the last swarm, and we do not have the grenade launcher. The most effective ways to kill the bulls is like you saw. We throw the C4 with the Here Kitty, we take advantage of the 5 seconds and nuke the bull with our primary weapon, and after around 5 seconds we detonate the C4, which is probably more than enough to finish off the bull. In preparation for the swarm attack, just be careful here as you search for defenses. There are always claymores around the area, do not step on them, and only use your breaching charge here in case there is a spare breaching charge here below the track, because we need 100% of the time to save the breaching charge for the last swarm, as defenses there, they are quite more essential compared to this attack. Other essential things we need to consider while in preparation for the first swarm is to save our improved MGL for the last swarm, as it has 17 rounds and it will be quite essential to deal with the last swarm, so switch it up with any different heavy weapon you find, and as always you do prefer weapons that deal explosive damage such as the RPG, the payload rifle, or if you find an extra MGL, feel free to use that, but that's not will not always be the case. You will also have to save at least one defense kit, and the defense kit are in priority to save. The most useful is the auto turret. After that, you can save either a voltage grid or a barbed wire, or even if you find two heavy machine guns, just save a heavy machine gun, anything will help. In order to save some time, you need to trigger the dialogue in order to start the countdown. You can do so by moving as you saw in the large mountain of the last Zeek. Then you can move backward to start placing the defenses. I do like to place the defenses here on top of the cars on the right, the heavy machine gun. And after I have placed and I have replaced my weapon, I do like to immediately start the swarm. Not only we save time, we save, we can avoid an attack from specials, although this wasn't the case, I wasn't so lucky, but we did manage to avoid any extensive attack, and only two bulls and I think a bomber spawned. Defending against the first swarm is pretty straightforward. You just use your heavy machine gun or the mortar to thin out the swarm as it comes. It will not be enough to finish it all off. After that, you can use only your primary weapon, and you just have to be careful if a bomber or a bull spawn from behind to have ready the C4 with her kitty. And as soon as the Zeke will usually come around and will not kill the bots or you, they will go for the gate where you can use your heavy weapon to finish them off. And usually your bots will cover you for the idle Zeke that will be coming upstairs. Here you saw the bad example of a chain reaction. An infector went down, the bot went downstairs to finish him off, and it got trampled to death. The other bot tried to raise him up and caused the chain reaction, as you all know, killing all the bots. But usually that's not the case. All your bots most of the times will be alive and will be able to help you. Here on the left, 99% of the time, you will find a spare of supply bag, which you can use without any problem. Don't afraid to deplete your supply bags if more special will come, more special Zeke, because you will find plenty of supply bags as you proceed forward. And before you trigger the dialogue, make sure to reset your bot's health. Just be sure that the doors are not open, because as soon as they are open, you will not be able to reset their health. And at that point, you will have to wait for them to respawn in a later stage. When you can do, you can just wait, but it's a long wait, and I don't recommend to just waste my time when you can just reset their health here. For the small next upcoming section, you will see the, I think, potential final breaching charge location, and apart from that, two or three areas where you will be able to find supply bags and or medkits. As I told you in the previous part, feel free to use your equipment to fend off the Zeke and make things easier. After you open these shutters, make sure to search the area fast. There is a chance to find a supply crate here. If you do not find it, do not waste time, because many Zeke will spawn with a chance of special Zeke, making you waste resources. So you have to walk this door, and after you walk inside, this is a safe area, the door closes, and you have the time to check the area. Here there is a guaranteed chance for a medkit, and you can wait if your bots are dead. Take a little time before proceeding to the next part, which is probably the hardest for the mission. If you are a little familiar with the level, you know that you have to place 6 in total explosives, and the bad thing in extreme, you do not get the indication for the locations to pick up the explosives, but as soon as you pick them up, you will get the indication for where to place them. Each location you find will have 2 explosives, meaning you have to find 3 locations with explosives to place them. As in many cases, there are 2 scenarios here. One, that you will make noise. I don't know what are the criteria. Your bots, you will have the primary weapons outside. You will make noise. And the downside here is that more Zeke will spawn, including special Zeke throughout the level, and more frequently, making things a little harder for you to deal with the Zeke. And the second scenario is that it will be a stealth part. Your bots will only have their secondary weapons, no special Zeke apart from the Lurker will spawn, making things easier. I did try to find a consistent way to make the bots go stealth mode. I found one way, but it's not consistent, it's very risky, and it requires a lot of build-up. You just need to finish off two of the bots in the safe room, leave one of the bot, trigger the attack, go inside the safe room where there is a choke point, and fend off the waves. And when all the two waves or three are down, you finish off the bot, remain alone, and then you will go in stealth mode. Your character stay. There is a chance for your character to stay quiet, and the bots that will spawn with the secondary weapons. But as I told you, it's not consistent. Sometimes you will remain alone, and an attack with special Z will come. Your bots will respawn with their primary weapons, and you just wasted your time and resources. And I just abandoned this track, and I decided to just go with a more traditional way of dealing with of this part. With that in mind, unfortunately, we have to proceed with a more traditional way, moving forward, finding explosives while fending off the Zeke and special Zeke. But there are some things to keep in mind that will make things easier. For starters, is as you saw here, although I have a charge and I know the location, I do not place it immediately. You have to fend off most of the Zeke before doing so, because your bots will not 100% cover you, especially if they are special Zeke. Make good use of your hair kitty. Throw your C4 when you get overwhelmed, or at least save one C4 for the bulls. It's quite essential. And as I told you, you throw the C4, wait for 4 to 5 seconds, nuke the bull, and detonate the C4, killing the bull in the process. Around the area, there are some locations where you will find supply bags to replenish your equipment. Make sure to memorize them, because you have to replenish your C4. They are your most valuable resource to survive, especially fending off the special Zeke or the Zeke that are spawning. Usually the Zeke are spawning from 1, 2 or 3 points, and you can get pincer attack, and the C4 can give you the breather, and you can take full advantage of the hair kitty talent. If you just throw the C4, you can wait 3 to 4 seconds for all the Zeke to gather before you detonate it. You don't have to kill all the Zeke with the C4. You can just use it to try to attract them, which is quite useful and will help you to survive throughout the level. Just to summarize, stick together with all your bots. Do not leave the heavy lifting to them. Kill as many Zeke as possible. Save your C4 if you get pincer attack overwhelmed by Zeke or special Zeke. Memorize the locations for the extra supply bags. Do not place the explosives if you see too many Zeke around. The bots will not be able to cover you. Sometimes you can also go down even by one remaining Zeke, because this is extreme difficulty. And be extra careful about the lurkers. Sometimes they have instant respawn rate, which can be quite painful. And even if you kill one, another one can lurk in the corner and can get you down very, very easily. So be extra careful about the lurkers, and sometimes you will not be able to hit them before you move forward. Just make sure to watch the corners as you move around. After you place the 6th and final explosive, you can move to this door, open it. Your bots will spawn if they're dead, and if you are getting attacked, you can just move forward, go outside. You will have the time to take a breather and finish off any Zeke that will come from the door, so you don't have to worry about it. Here you see an example that your bots are in stealth mode, and although overall things are easier, meaning that you don't have to deal with any special Zeke apart from the lurkers in the corners, but once again you have to do all the heavy lifting using most of the times your primary weapon, silenced, because your bots do not have enough firepower to help you and cover you, which can make things a little tricky, especially if you underestimate the Zeke attacks. So be careful while placing the explosives, and you can use your C4 with only Hair Kitty to distract the Zeke in case you get overwhelmed, which is quite unlikely, but in case you happen to get, as I told you, too many Zeke to deal with, just use your C4 to take a breather. Do not detonate it, and as long as you do that, you will not make noise and your bots will stay in stealth mode, making things a little easier. As you proceed in the area in between the final swarm, you can search around. There is a high chance to find supply, create supply bag, Just be a little careful to not be as greedy as I was here. In case you try to use your resources, your bots will not be able always to cover you, and you just trading resources with ones you found. In case you want to get all the supply bags, use all the medkits, make sure to finish off all the Zeke before doing so. Otherwise, run for it in order to avoid getting extra damage and wasting, as I told you, resources. As always, careful around the corners for any lurkers that may hide. And as you walk downstairs, check on the left. There is a chance to find resources below the stairs here or on top of the desk. And before you open the door is your last chance to reset your bot's health. If you are here, do not finish off any of the bots. Otherwise, they will not be available for the last swarm. And here is a good opportunity to finish off any remaining Zeke, especially if you have the resources, because as soon as you drop here, a timer will start where you need to apply the defenses for the last swarm. In preparation for the last swarm, I do like to follow this route. Open this breaching door, use the defense I have, usually I save the auto turret. I always apply the auto turret here, it will cover the Zeke that are coming and the gate, and start applying any other defenses. If you find a heavy machine gun, there are two good spots to place them. One is here to defend against one of the swarm attacks, and the other is on the front gate, you will see, to defend against the other. And another surprisingly high priority is to save the soldier on top of this Humvee you saw, the white Humvee, because he is very useful and he will distract the upcoming Zeke for the swarm. The other potential locations for defenses are in the boat that you saw. I found a defense here, and sometimes behind these crates there is a supply crate or a defense kit, although I don't usually have the time to check this location out, and I usually prioritize other things. Here is the location for the heavy machine gun. We can search also behind this truck that you will see. Sometimes there are defense kits, heavy weapon and supply crates. And as you saw, we replaced our MGL because we need to make sure to save this improved MGL with a 17 shot for the swarm attack that will be coming from the center, which is the tunnel, as it's the hardest swarm to defend against, and the MGL is the perfect choice to defend against it. Most of the times the first swarm attack comes from the left, which we will use this heavy weapon to deal with it, as we need to, as I told you, save the MGL for the center, this heavy weapon for the left, and in case the swarm comes from the right, as it's in this instance, we will use a heavy machine gun and our tier 3 weapon. You see that the bots are taking the predestined locations, that's why you know where the swarm will be coming from. In case it comes from the right, use your heavy machine gun to thin out the swarm. Just don't deplete it completely, leave around 100-110 bullets to deal with the pyramids that will come from the water, and be extra careful, since you're on top of the boat, many special Zeke have a high chance to spawn on top of the boat, such as bulls, bombers, which is the most dangerous one, and the gas bag, surprisingly dangerous, the gas cloud can kill you easily. In that case, make sure to use your, as you see here, C4, finish off the bulls as soon as you can, and continue to dealing with the swarm and the pyramids below. As always, don't forget to restock your armor in between swarms, and for the left swarm attack, we will take our position here, where we have a perfect angle to deal with the lurker that spawns here usually, and all the Zeke that will come from the fence. Make sure to save your heavy weapon when the Zeke pyramid up. It will help a lot to deal with the initial attack. As you see here, most of the Zeke are dead. Use your tier 3 weapon to deal with the rest. The bots have already taken position and will be quite a help to finish them off quite easily. And don't forget to go grab your MGL and prepare for the upcoming swarm that will come from the center, which is one of the, let's say, hardest, but since we have the improved MGL, we will see we won't have so much problem. In case you are lucky and have an extra heavy machine gun, start using that on the swarm. Just be careful to not hit the bot that is on the left. Here you see Hiroji. And in case you do not have the heavy machine gun, use your tier 3 weapon. Place yourself a little bit behind the barbed wire, and when the swarm comes close enough, switch to your heavy MGL which we will not spam it in order to be able to kill all the Zeke. In case bulls come from the left, you can use your C4 and one MGL shot is more than enough to finish them off. And as you see here on the right, the soldier on top of the Humvee draws a lot of aggro from the Zeke, which helps a lot to deal with this swarm attack. And don't be afraid, even if one or two of your bots go down, you will have the time to bring them up after the swarm is dead, and they will be able to help you fend off the rest of the attack. As always, don't forget to restock everything, your ammo and your auto turret. And for the last swarm, when 30 around seconds remain, in this case it comes from the left, we will use most of our resources here to fend off most of the attack and deal with it using our tier 3 weapon and C4 and any other resources we have. Just make sure to save one or two C4s in case some special Zeke spawn from the boat. As soon as you see the timer goes around 3 to 2 seconds, run for the boat there. Even if the Zeke come and try to overwhelm the gate, you will be able to defend it from here. And you just have to wait until the blue line appears, where you will be able to finish off the level. And that was basically Tokyo 2 Final Call. This was the strategy I thought it's the best and easiest for you to deal with all the situation, especially for the second part and the last swarm, which is arguably the most, let's say, challenging parts of the mission. But hopefully, using these tactics, you will not have a problem. As always, I will leave a part without commentary in the end, that I used another build with Hellraiser once again, but I had the grenade launcher instead of the improved MGL to see other tactics I used to deal with the swarm. And if you are literally, as I told you, more experienced with the level, you don't have to use the same class or same tactics. The exterminator is quite good, for especially for this last part and for the first swarm. And also the slasher can be better for the second part, and the first part is okay, but here for the last part, because for the packs we usually we all just stay here and defend. You cannot do this with the bots, because all your bots will go to pre-testing locations, and they, if you leave them alone, they will most likely die, leaving you alone to defend against the whole swarm. Feel free to leave any comments and any other suggestions you may have in the section below. I really hope you enjoyed the video and you find it helpful in any way. Stay tuned for more upcoming videos for the World War Z and other video games. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all a great day.
Let's see them get past this. Take a look at this. Auto turret set. Check it out.
We should be proud of what we've done here.
It has been an honor.
Mowing them down. Throwing a remote charge. This should help.
Many thanks.
Reload!
All crew aboard.
These.
Now loading the last of the cargo.
From the fuel depot! Take them out! These meds will help.
I owe you one.
All that practice paid off. Right side. They're coming from the water. Mowing them down. Reaper. Is everybody okay?
Bring that screamer down!
Fire on the tunnel!
Crane's clear. Drop in the lines. Let's go!
Throwing a remote charge!
This isn't over.